Hello learners, welcome to the another lecture of Emerging Domain in Electronics Engineering. In today's lecture, we will calculate the output voltage for the various circuits of op-amp like adder, integrator, differentiator and subtractor. We have already discussed that op-amp can perform mathematical operations like addition, integration, differentiation and subtraction. So in this lecture, we will use negative feedback in the op-amp circuit and see how does an op-amp work as an adder, integrator, differentiator and subtractor. So let's start. First of all, we will see the circuit of adder. And it is also called summer because it sums up the input voltages. And the circuit is like this. We will use negative feedback here. And the negative feedback is fed through a feedback resistor RF and series resistor R1. And whatever voltages we want to add, we will apply at the same point. That means we are going to use inverting configuration, all connected with a resistor. You can place another resistor here like this. And now, as we can see, the currents will flow like I1, I2, I3, and let us assume the current in the feedback resistor is I4. Now again we will apply the virtual ground concept, and by applying virtual ground concept, if we consider this as point X, then the potential at point X is zero because the potential of non-inverting terminal appears at the inverting terminal. So as the potential at non-inverting terminal is zero right now, so it will appear at the point X, and therefore if we will apply KCL at point X, then the equation of currents that we will get is I1 plus I2 plus I3. I'm sorry, I have written it. This one is I2, this one is I3. So I1, I2 and I3 is equal to I4. I hope it is clear to all. Now we will apply nodal analysis over here, and if we apply nodal analysis for I1, it will be V1 minus 0 upon R1 plus V2 minus 0 upon R2 plus V3 minus 0 upon R3, and for I4 it will be 0 minus V0 upon RF. So if you will solve V0 from here, it will come out to be minus RF into V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3. So in laboratory, if we want to verify op-amp as an adder, then we keep all the values of resistances equal. That means R1 equal to R2 equal to R3 equal to RF equal to R. So all the resistances will be put equal, and from there you will get minus R divided by R, because this R will be equal for all, and it will be V1 plus V2 plus V3. So it will be minus of V1 plus V2 plus V3. So minus sign only indicates that the output is 180 degree out of phase with respect to the input signals. So it simply will give you the sum of the all input voltages. So this is how an adder or a summer is verified in the laboratories. Now we'll move on to the next part, that is integrator. Very important from exam point of view. Now again we will use the inverting configuration of op-amp and with the negative feedback. So let's start drawing the circuit first of all. Now in the case of integrator, The negative feedback will not be fed through a feedback resistor. In fact, there will be a capacitor in the feedback. So in the case of integrator, we need to remember this, that we have a capacitor in the feedback, else everything is same. That is inverting configuration, therefore Vi is here and this is grounded. So again, let's show the directions of current also, I1 and I2. Now again, according to virtual ground concept, let us consider this point as X. According to virtual ground concept, the potential of non-inverting terminal will appear at the inverting terminal, and hence the potential at the point X is zero. So we will apply KCL again at point X, and we'll get I1 is equal to I2. Now on applying nodal analysis, what we get is Vi minus 0 upon R, and instead of I2, what we will get, now look at the right hand side. See, I in the capacitor is equal to C dV/dt, isn't it? C dV/dt, that means current in a capacitor is capacitance into the rate of change of voltage across it. So by applying this, as I2 is the current in the capacitor, so therefore what we will do is C into d/dt of what is the voltage across capacitor that you were going to do the subtraction, like according to nodal analysis. So it would have been 0 minus V0. So Vi upon R is equals to C d minus dV0/dt. Now you need to calculate V0 from here. So first of all, you will bring minus 1 upon RC, minus 1 upon RC, then Vi is equals to dV0/dt. And if we want to calculate V0 from here, and we need to remove this differentiation, so we'll put the constant outside and we will integrate the other part. So it is Vi dt. So this is what is the output of integrator. So this is how the op-amp works as an integrator. So the only thing we need to remember is that in the place of feedback resistor, we are going to place here a feedback capacitor, and the current in the capacitor is not written similar to the way we write in the case of resistor. In fact, you can write it in a very simple manner by recalling this formula, that is I equal to C dV/dt. Now when we will study differentiator, just look at the circuit diagram of integrator very carefully. You just need to swap the positions of capacitor and resistor in the case of differentiator. So let's draw the diagram for differentiator. It's like we just need to swap the positions of resistor and capacitor in integrator. So this is how we draw the diagram of differentiator. Again, we'll consider this point to be X, and according to virtual ground concept, the potential of non-inverting terminal will appear at the inverting terminal, and therefore the potential at point X will be zero. So now we will again apply KCL at X point, and by applying KCL, we will see that I1 is equal to I2. Again, nodal analysis. Now I1 is the current in the capacitor. Again, we'll apply the same formula, C dV/dt. Now C, instead of C, we have C only, d/dt, and what is the voltage across it? Vi minus 0 is equal to I2, 0 minus V0 upon R. Now what is V0 here? V0 is simply minus RC dVi/dt. So you are simply differentiating the input voltage, and that is how an op-amp works as a differentiator. So these are the ways in which op-amp works as an adder, differentiator and integrator. Now we will see how op-amp is used as a subtractor or difference amplifier. So let's see it. subtractor or difference amplifier. Difference amplifier. Let's draw the diagram. It's a bit different from the other circuits. Similarly, we are using a negative feedback here. Now we will have to apply two voltages because we need to subtract. So we need two voltages. So one is like this and the other we will apply at the non-inverting terminal but not directly in this manner. So this is how we draw the circuit for the difference amplifier. Just observe it very carefully and see. Now let the voltage at this point be Vx, and the same Vx will appear at point X according to virtual ground concept. Because according to the virtual ground concept, the potential of non-inverting terminal will appear at the inverting terminal. Now in order to solve this circuit, we are not going to apply the same strategy as we were doing in the previous circuits, that is to apply KCL at point X, then apply nodal analysis and hence calculate V0. Here the scenario is somewhat different. Here we will apply the superposition principle. Now what is superposition principle? According to the superposition principle, we will inactivate or we will make one of the voltage sources dead. That means we will ground them. We will ground them and then we will calculate the output voltage due to one of the sources that is left active. So, and then we will add both the output voltages. And then we will add both the output voltages. So apply superposition principle here. Apply superposition principle. And first case, what will be the first case? We will make one of the voltage sources as zero and we will keep one active. So we are keeping V1 active and V2 is zero. So V0 will be due to V1. Let us name as V out 1. Now what is V out 1? Just imagine V2 to be ground, and when V2 is grounded, the whole non-inverting terminal is grounded because it is as a whole connected to the ground. Now it becomes an inverting amplifier. Just look at the diagram very carefully. If we make V2 0, the whole non-inverting terminal will be grounded, and this configuration will be similar to that of an inverting configuration. So what was the output of inverting configuration that we discussed in the previous lecture? I have also shared the link of the previous lecture in the description box. So that was V out 1 equals to minus of RF by R1 into V1. So V out 1 is simply like this. Now case 2, now we will make V2 active and V1 0. So V1 is 0 now and V2 is active, and now V2 will be due to the V0 will be due to the V2, so it will be V out 2. Now V out 2, let's see what the V out 2 will be. Now imagine V1 to be grounded, okay, and now it becomes a non-inverting configuration. You remember that in the case of non-inverting configuration, we were applying the input voltage at the non-inverting terminal, and the inverting terminal was grounded like this with the negative feedback. So similarly here also, it becomes a non-inverting amplifier, but in the case of non-inverting amplifier, the output was 1 plus RF by R1 into the voltage that was taken was just outside the non-inverting terminal, that is Vx. Now we need to calculate Vx in terms of V2 so that we can put here Vx in terms of V2 and we can get the answer of V out 2 in terms of V0, V2. So let us see what is Vx. Vx is, according to potential divider rule, Vx is the voltage in the R3, and R2 and R3 are in series. So we need to calculate the voltage only across one resistor. So we will apply potential divider rule. Total voltage into the resistance into which you are calculating the voltage, that is R3, upon total resistance R2 and R3. So now Vx is V2 into R3 upon R2 plus R3. We'll put the same value in the answer. V out 2 is equal to 1 plus Rf by R1 into V2 R3 upon R2 plus R3. Now, just calculate the total V0, which is V out 1 plus V out 2, and it is minus Rf by R1 into V1 plus 1 plus Rf by R1 into V2 R3 upon R2 plus R3. Now it will be very easy for you to understand if you put all these resistances equal. So let us put all the resistances equal and you will simply get the answer V0 equals to minus of V1 minus V2 or V2 minus V1. So you will simply get the difference of the two voltages when you will put all the resistances equal in value. So this is how an op-amp works as an adder, subtractor, differentiator and integrator. I hope you all